Yes. So now we are going to another type of a question. What is the number whose 16% is shining? Whose 16% is 76. So there is a certain number which we have to find out. And when you did 16% of that number, you got 76. So first you need to understand the question. What you did the other day was to find the value. In that, what did you do? In finding the value, what was given? Say for example, 10% of say 35 was given. 35 kg. So when you did 10% of 35 kg, what will you get? 10% of 35 kg will be 10/100. Of 35 kg, then you will reduce 0, both are divisible by 10. What is left? 35 upon 10. You can reduce this further, but because it is a decimal fraction, it is easy for me to write it as a decimal number, so I am not reducing it. Okay, it will become 3.5 kg. You want to reduce it, finally, you will get the same answer. If you reduce it, it will become 5 sevens are 5 fives are. So 7 upon 5 means 5 twos are, sorry. 7 upon 2 means 2 divide 7 3 times, 1 will be left upon 2. So whether it is 3.5 or whether it is 3.5, it is one and the same. Now, what is this 3.5 or 3.5? It is 10% of 35 kg. Now, this question is very similar to this in the sense that it is the opposite of this. In this, you had to find the percentage of a given quantity. You found out this much percent of this. Okay? And in this question, what is it? This number is not given. The number whose percentage you have found out, that number is not given. And you have to find out that number. So what is the number? So what is this number? Whose 16%? So you did 16% of that number and you got 76. So when you did 10% of 35, you got 3.5. So the question, if this question I'm supposed to ask for this one, then how would it be? What is the number whose 10% is 3.5, then my answer would be 35. Okay, so it is the find the value question, but given in another way, wherein the value is already given to you. Here you are finding out the value, you are finding out 10% of a certain number. Here what is happening? That number whose percent you have found out is not given. So you know the value and you know the percentage. You don't know what the number is. So out of these three things, these two are given. And in the earlier one, these two used to be given, you used to find out this third one. So first understand the question, what is the number whose 16%? So you did 16% of a particular number and you got 76. So let me write that as an equation. So whatever is given here in words, I will write it in figures. So 16% of the required number means the number that we want. So when we did 16% of the required number, we got the answer 76. Now, that required number, instead of writing such a big thing, you can simply write X. Okay? So 16% of X equals 76. Okay? Now 16%. Solve one thing at a time. 16% means 16 upon 100 of X equals 76. Now what happens? We'll keep the unknown on one side and all the knowns we take to one side. We have done these type of questions earlier. So I'll let x remain here before the equal to sign. I'll let 76 also remain there after the equal to sign. I will take this to the other side. Now when this goes to the other side, you have to write the opposite always. So this will be written as 100 upon 16 when it goes to the other side. Actually, why does it become 100 upon 16 also? Let me explain to you. Off means multiply. Okay? So when this goes to the other side, it becomes divide. So what happens is x equals 76. These both things are as they are. And this which is multiplied will become divide by 16 upon 100. Okay. So here it is multiplication. So when it goes to the other side, it becomes division. So what will happen in the next step? X equals 76 multiplied by 100 upon 16. So you can see that we have to do the reciprocal of any fraction which is here. When it goes to the other side, it becomes the reciprocal of that. Okay. So in the solution that I have done, I have not shown this particular step. I have straight away written this. But here I have explained it to you that how this becomes the reciprocal. So here the multiplication will change to division when it goes to the other side of the equal to sign, and then the divide changes to multiplication and reciprocal of this fraction. Now reduce whatever can be reduced, and that will be your required number. Okay, both of these are divisible. Okay, both of these are divisible by 4. 4 divides 4 times and 4 divides 25 times. Now 4, does it divide this one? Yes. 4 divides 1. 4 1s are 4. 3 will remain 36. 4 9s are 36. So 19 into 25. Now you can do it, do the multiplication smartly. 25, instead of 19, you multiplied by 20. So 25 2s are how much? 50. And 20s are 500. From that you minus 1, 25. Because this is 19, isn't it? So 8, 25, you may say minus karo. How much will you get? 4, 75. So that is how you can also use smart multiplication. So I had to multiply 25 by 19. So I did not multiply by 19. It is easy for me to multiply by 20. So I multiplied 25 by 20. 25 into 20 is 500. And I wanted to multiply only by 19. So 825 usme se nikal diya kyunki 20 mein 825 zyada hai aur mujhe 19 se multiply karna tha, so I removed 125 from that. So x is 425. So if you want to check your answer, you can do it. Now you have got that 16% of a required number, and that required number we found out is 475. So when you do 16% of 475, you should get 76. Then this number of yours is correct.